I cannot believe you're wearing the same pants. Truly. What kind of pants are those? Where did you get those pants?
Yeah.
Gotta give a shout out to homie.
You have a little crotch stain on that one, buddy, too?
Yeah.
Wash your pants. If you're going to wear the same pants. I am the Zach Monson. We are here in the beautiful Galaxy offices in the Old Port of Montreal with Montreal's very own Adventure Club. So you guys have been playing music together for a long ass time.
Yeah.
So you guys were in the punk band whole thing, the hardcore thing. What was that kind of song that you heard that made you say, I can do that electronic thing. I can do that dubstep game.
It was actually really a reasonably obscure song. It's by this guy named Tiesto, and it's Levels, I think, was the.
Oh, that's not by Z. I thought that was by Z. 20
a year ago.
Tiesto.
Oh no.
The whole Levels thing is a little passe, I think, buddy. I'll give it to you.
No, we the Bring Me the Horizon. We had a remix. Of one of their songs by this group called Tech One.
No, Tech One did a remix of a song by Bring Me the Horizon. You said it the other way around.
No, he said it the right way.
He said Bring Me the Horizon did a remix of a Tech One song.
No, he said there was a remix of by.
Oh. At least one of us is listening.
Pay attention.
Well, the song was called Sleep With One Eye Open.
Okay. And from that point onwards. Were you any good when you started?
No,
horrible.
I feel like the answer is probably not. What did you start on? Are you still using the same software that you started on?
Yeah.
Which is?
Sonar Producer X3.
Sonar.
Cakewalk.
Which is Cakewalk.
Yeah.
So other than the fact that myself and Galaxy has been playing your music since early 2011, what do you consider the point where you realized that Adventure Club was going to be a big thing?
Really recently, I think it was just Coachella. That was like when we were kind of on the come up, our manager and us made this list of goals we wanted to kind of check off.
Yeah.
And Coachella
it's called
was
a checklist. A list of goals that we wanted to check off.
Okay. And Coachella was top of the list?
It was at the bottom.
Okay, the last one.
Going from minimalistic to biggest dream.
Yeah, first
on
one was like,
don't
get
pants.
Get someone to buy our flight to get to a show.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Second one was like, groupie. Third one was like, there was like 20 of them in Coachella.
The second one was kill our first groupie.
Okay, so if not killing people in music, what would you guys be doing?
I wasn't done that question.
Sorry, you want to continually go on to...
Number one was playing Coachella, headlining this hard tent.
Yeah.
Number two, which happened a bit earlier, was when Crave You became the number one song
for strippers
to
dance
to.
Yep.
I'll tell you, I got so stoked for you guys when I heard that, and I knew that you would be stoked. I knew that you went out that night and partied just because of that celebration.
Huge celebration.
Yeah, I remember
went
congratulating
to,
Super
Sex, Club Super Sex.
Celebration.
We went to Wanda's.
Wanda's.
Which is now closed, I think?
No. What? No, it's open.
What are we doing
tonight? No, it's open. It's definitely there. I mean, two strip clubs in my life, Wanda's, MTL, and I got kicked out of MTL. I won't tell that story, but I'll tell you after.
Was this recent?
Yeah, it was recent.
Is your wife watching?
Tell me about the concept of Superheroes Anonymous.
Well,
yeah.
Obviously, we are nighttime DJs
nighttime
and later
DJs?
In the night superheroes.
Okay. Okay, genius.
Our night job is DJing. Our later night job is things.
Okay, so we'll skip that one. That was a terrible answer. You guys recently released Superheroes Anonymous number 5, Road Trip Edition. The music choices you guys seem to have are all over the place, from Montel Jordan to Katy Perry to Skrillex to Fall Out Boy. Lots of Canadian access time, including my boys, Wonderful. I'm really glad you included
TV1.
David A, TV1, good Montreal boys.
TV1 was our first cameo. He asked us to be
okay.
In
wait,
video.
Hold on. It had to be his video for Barbara Streisand.
That's
then.
You know
it. Yeah, I remember it very well. That's actually how I heard about TV1 was because of that video. Weirdly enough, so how do you guys go about picking the songs that go into your mixes?
It's whatever we're listening to.
We look at the best songs that you guys play on Galaxy and put them all together.
That is a great
and it
answer.
Turns out very poorly.
That's we
scour blogs and we'll get a list of 200 songs, and then we'll just sit down and really try to make a cohesive mix. But it's kind of hard when you're jumping genres so much. But we try to make it flow pretty well.
So we asked the last band that was here to ask you guys a question. And I'll show you that question now. That is Cedric from Klingon.
Hi, I'm Klingon. I have one question for you. Who is your favorite saxophone player?
Who's our favorite sexual predator?
No. Cedric. You guys know Klingon, the song Jubal. So Cedric was in, and he wants to know, who is your favorite saxophone player?
Sexual predator.
This one is really easy.
Our favorite sexual.
Oh,
absolutely.
Yeah.
I had one answer. I don't know who you're going to possibly say.
Are we going to say it on the count of three? One, two, three. Dom from Big G.
I was going to say Dominic Lally. But
well, Dom, I said Dom from Big G, Big Gigantic.
You actually have an answer. Yeah. Mine was like Lisa Simpson. That's the only sax player I could possibly even.
Lisa is
a weirdo.
The song Wonder. Great track. You've kind of crossed that whole electronic music boundary and moved into the whole top 40 mainstream thing. In fact, recently you guys made it to the Billboard top 40 of the Canadian Hop 100. So tell me a bit about writing the song and how you guys got hooked up with Kitespring Tangle and how you feel about being in top 40 radio now.
We were kind of on SoundCloud just looking for new music, and the Kitespring Tangle popped up. I think he had like 100 followers, like not many plays on his songs, and we were like, wow, this guy's a ridiculously good voice, kind of in the vein of Dan from Bastille. We got our manager to hit him up, and he sent us vocals.
I think, and then we sent them back because they were really bad.
And how did he react? I mean, like having Adventure Club, which is a pretty well-known band.
I don't think he knew us at the time.
No, he had no idea who we were.
Really?
Yeah, he's from Australia. The whole thing over there is really weird.
You've been there before. Yeah. You played there a bunch.
No, it's not weird. Just they have different tastes.
I'm actually Australian myself, so watch your mouth.
They have the best of taste. Like the music on the radio in Australia is
Triple J for a pop station. Is unreal.
Like I'm so proud every time I'm there.
Yeah,
and Wonder almost didn't even make the EP.
Well, just time-wise, it's not like we were cutting it. Yeah, we just got the vocal like so late, we had no plans to put it on the EP, and it was just going to be like potentially a song sometime, and it came together like 3 days before the release was supposed to be scheduled, and we're like, fuck, we got to make this part of the EP, and
then it
became the single just magically within 3 days of the release date.
We had an idea for the instrumental from another song that we were working on before.
And then we kind of...
Yeah.
Wholesale.
It was painful how we had to release the vocal from that the song was originally on. But.
And were you surprised that you kind of made it to this whole top 40 grouping of artists now? Because that's not really your thing. I mean, you're not really going for the whole pop act vibe. Meh, play it, don't play it, whatever. Okay, good.
No, we're
that's the entire answer.
I'll make sure we take it off Galaxy. That's fine, no problem. That's fine.
Thanks so much for playing it. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem, bro. I think it's on actually three. It's on three of our channels now.
Oh, wicked.
So you're welcome.
I don't think it's really hit us that it's breached the top 40. I saw it was... Never mind.
Yeah, what were you going to say? Finish it?
I was going to say your next question.
Yeah, which was?
Paper, Billboard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I already brought that up. You just weren't paying attention.
No, you did.
You said something about top 40.
There
Billboard.
You go.
I definitely
brought it up.
I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, neither of you are paying attention at all. It's fine.
it's super surreal.
Yeah, I think it's cool. So, you know, speaking of the next album, you guys should be having something come out soon, right? There should be another album in the works fairly...
The album, maybe not soon, okay. But we have a couple singles coming out in the next couple months.
Okay.
Few months. Has he heard any of it?
I've heard the one that you did the ghost vocals on.
No. Leighton's really not good at keeping you in the loop. He's a bad friend.
I expect things way before they're released.
I will send you everything.
Good.
The day before they're released.
Good.
We're excited about
it. Who would you guys love to have on a track with you? Who would you love to do music with?
Cat Power.
Really?
Yeah.
That's super cool.
Johnny Craig.
She won't respond to any
Who
of
is
my
Johnny
tweets.
Craig?
Well, you know, maybe you should know.
I don't. Who is Johnny Craig? Tell me about who's Johnny Craig.
Dance Gavin Dance, Amorosa. Somebody.
He's like one of our idols.
He's the dude with
up.
The best voice in the world.
Okay, I'll be YouTubing that later tonight. That's fine. I heard today, or it could have been yesterday, that you guys have officially been banned from how many hotels?
We made it 24 last night. It was 23 when I tweeted it.
I saw 23, and now it's 24?
24, Atlantic City, Tuesday night.
Okay, what are you doing that you think you're so rock star that you're getting kicked out and banned from 24 hotels?
This wasn't my fault,
because
I don't remember.
Can I tell one of them?
Oh,
because I like
so it's not your fault because you don't remember.
I woke up, and there was just a giant hole in a porcelain sink.
I want to tell a good Leighton Hotel story, okay?
Lend you want to get cozy? You're good?
Lend me your ear. Once upon a time, we're in, I think it was Peterborough. No, not Peterborough.
Sudbury.
Sudbury. We're okay. in Sudbury.
Ontario,
And we somehow actually know some people out in Sudbury. I have no idea how. They come out to the show. We're having a good time. It's a good party. And one of the people with us gets, like, belligerently drunk, like, yeah. like beyond,
was it
like the, it wasn't like, and he, like, at the end of the show, he wasn't even in the venue because he gotten in like three fights, fell down a flight of stairs and got kicked out. So he was waiting outside. We all went back to the hotel and he was basically like the star of the show. He was just so drunk that everyone was just like all eyes on him at all times. And at some point at the hotel room, when we were just like watching his drunken antics, we all kind of turned around at the same time, and Leighton is ass naked, like 100% naked, standing behind us, sees that we see him, gets like deer in headlights eyes, turns around and busts through the hotel door, like breaks the door. He broke the hinge off the door into the hallway, and he just sprints down the hallway. And I pop out just in time to see him like bull rush into the wall at the end of the hallway, just straight down. He went down like a rock.
Well, that's a great segue to my next question. EDM and dance music has a negative connotation sometimes with the party
segue.
Vibe and
that's
the drug scene
and
the drinking scene. So you guys have kind of made an effort to do a lot of good. You do a lot of charity work, do a lot of good. How'd you guys get hooked up with, you know, the LA Food Bank and Fuck Cancer?
Most of that stuff we do with our good friends in Electric Family. We linked up with them about a year and a half ago, and we started talking about how we could kind of better the community, kind of get rid of those connotations. So we started these, these charity bracelets.
Mm-hmm.
We linked up with them. Our bracelets are red and blue, and all the proceeds from them go to Fuck Cancer.
I mean, but you can pick up, obviously, like they have all kinds of artists.
Yeah.
You pick up any of them, they're all going to their specific...
Every artist has a different charity.
There's Corella,
Blau,
yeah.
Martin Schultz.
There's a lot of
Romero just got one.
Pick them up, collect them all.
Yeah.
Do good.
So why is it important for you guys to do good?
I mean, aside from just the
fact that you're doing good, yeah.
The intrinsic value.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, it's I think it's nice to show how much good there is in the scene, and that the crowd and all the people who go, it's not just about like partying and drugs and stuff. Like there is a lot of love and a lot of kind of a tightly knit community.
And I think everyone in the community knows how good it is. It's just when it comes down to press and media, people only kind of tend to focus on the bad things that happen.
Yeah.
So we just.
I also want to talk about the next charity thing that we're going to do.
Please do.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not happened. It hasn't happened yet, so you can't look. But like, keep your eye open. What we're going to do is, we were talking before, and we were talking about how I'd been wearing this tank top.
Yeah.
Since October, about.
Yeah.
Since our
Please
bus tour.
Please don't say you're going to auction it off.
No. We're going to kickstart a Get Christian a New Tank Top. And there's just going to be like probably at least, I'd say at least like 60 pictures from different shows, just because I only play shows in this tank top. And once we decided with this idea, like I kind of like made even more of a point to just only wear this tank top. So now it's just so unreasonable. You won't be able to find a picture of me not in this very specific tank top. So the Kickstarter is going to be Get Me a New Tank Top.
Okay.
And I think the first $20 of the Kickstarter will go to getting me a new tank top, and I guess I'll have to wear it. And then the rest of it, we're hoping it kind of gets traction because it's a cool concept, is going to be given to kids in need, clothing kids in need.
Awesome.
Yeah. So
you're okay.
That's
going to
be the
eh?
Next one.
You're not the worst people ever.
We're going to try to tie it in with EF, obviously, Electric Family.
Cool.
We don't take after our trailer parks.
It's going to be fun. I'm going to get new clothes, which is always nice.
You are wearing the same pants. I really think you guys should not wear the same pants at the
uniform.
Same time.
You put these pants on and you try not to wear them.
Bring me a pair of pants next time.
Right, let's switch right now.
What size are you?
He's a 29.
32. I'm a fat dude, man.
I think
like,
everyone wants to see you in skinny jeans.
Skinny
There's
jeans?
Not one person in this room who does not want to see you
I can guarantee
into
you
jeans.
That all of my fellow employees in this room do
smiles
not
of consent.
Want to see me take off my pants.
I'm taking
guarantee.
Mine off right now.
Are you doing it?
Yeah. Are we switching?
Off.
Are we switching pants?
We're switching pants.
Get that belt off.
Okay.
Oh, those are nice.
Thanks, bro.
Those are very, very tight.
All right. can't wait to see Claire on the list.
Good luck.
Oh my god. You have little girl legs, man. What are you
talking about? No, they're collars. They're like little cuffs at the bottom.
Oh, you know what? Okay, so wait, you have tiny little girl legs but big waist.
Yeah, show him the bruise. That's from another time Leighton got kicked out of the hotel.
Oh, my word. You know what? These pants are pretty comfy, I gotta tell you. They're not bad. They're not bad at all. Yeah, shoes
I'm shocked at how well these are both fitting you guys.
it's pretty impressive. I like it, actually. It's pretty good. So let's quickly talk about Ilsonic. Ilsonic, big EDM festival coming to Montreal, finally. You have big old feet, eh? Put on by Evenco. No, I can see that by your tiny little bulge in my pants. That's fine. So, Ilsonic, are you guys excited for Ilsonic? What are you most excited for this
record,
brand
for
new EDM
festival? It's at least 4 inches bigger than yours.
What are we excited for? No, we actually are. Like, we've been talking about it for months about how excited we are. We get to pick our own stage.
You guys are kind of a big deal. You kind of are the act that have brought this whole festival to really happen, right? I mean,
hope we gave it a little character.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got our own stage, the Superheroes Anonymous stage. We got to pick all the acts on that stage.
Super honored.
Got to pick, like, the production on the stage, or at least work with them getting the production on the stage. Got some pyrotechnics, maybe.
And who are you most excited to see perform?
Not that Tiesto. We're going to get to see her.
Tiesto, because of that Levels.
Yeah, track that Levels track. Just drop the joke, man. It's been so many years, the Levels joke. Just drop it.
Iggy Azalea.
Yeah, I spiced it up because I didn't say Avicii.
Yeah, that's good.
Anna Luneau, I think, is there. Yeah. Pixel Boys. A lot of good acts playing.
So good acts. What's a great Canadian electronic act that people should get into?
Snails. Botneck.
Yeah, those.
Botneck, awesome.
Both from Montreal.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like everyone already knows. I still love Zed's Dead. Everyone knows who they are, though. So
his new stuff is cool. It's got some like groove to it. That new album is really cool. Whatever.
Zed's Dead?
That song, Lost.
Yeah, the new album is really good.
Really good.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got some really cool tunes on there.
That's awesome.
Not so much new, but everyone should revisit Bryan Adams. Summer 69.
You're not going to be ever welcome back here ever again. You're just never invited back ever again. You can hear Adventure Club on Galaxy's Hit List channel, Dance Clubbing channel, and Eclectic Electronic channel. Thank you, boys, for
and
coming by.
Adult
we appreciate
alternative.
It. And we'll see you about Adult
Alternative. Who picked your
it's
socks
probably not
out.
There. Who picked my socks?
Are you a Powerpuff Girl?
That's a great ending, Leighton. Tune in next time, guys.
Oh, got you.
Tune in next time. Monson and we are here at Oceaga, hanging out in the back of our RV in bed with Mr. Vance Joy himself. How are you, man?
I'm good.
How's
How
your
are
day
you going?
Been?
Yeah, great. Having such a good time.
The song on She's the Sister of a Friend. And we put the song on YouTube, on SoundCloud, and in a few weeks it was like a lot of view, and we was very. You can hear them saying, oh, oh, oh.